Right, at age 17, she became the youngest winner of the Miss America crown in 90 years.
But Teresa Scanlan is not stopping there. In fact, she's aiming for 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. That's right, the reigning Miss America. Teresa Scanlan joins us live. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Thank you so much.
You want to be president?
Absolutely.
You've got quite a plan, don't you?
I do. I would like to be a criminal prosecution attorney. I would like to then go on to become a judge and eventually join the political arena.
You're leaving out you would like to go to Harvard Law School.
Yes, absolutely. Okay. I have to complete my undergrad first, which will be next year. So there's a lot of years of school ahead. But in the future, we'll see how everything goes.
You're also leaving out that not only do you want to be president, but after president, you also have a retirement plan.
Absolutely. Yeah. As a Supreme Court justice.
That's right.
And that has been my plan ever since I was about 7 years old. Hasn't changed. But I really do think that I'm getting the experience that I need for it right now, and I want to all the more now.
Mm-hmm. If president, would you wear the crown in the White House?
No. Actually, after I'm done with my year as Miss America, I'm no longer allowed to wear it. Only the current reigning Miss America is allowed to wear the crown.
Okay. And if seen, you'll be fined?
I have no idea how that works, quite honestly.
Well, you have been up close and personal with the British royal family. Tell us about the Duke of Edinburgh Award, which has been ongoing.
Right. Well, we have spent the past 3 days with His Royal Highness Prince Edward, because the Duke of Edinburgh Award has a national partnership with the Miss America organization.
Okay.
And so Sam Haskell, who chairs the Miss America organization, also chairs the U.S. Duke of Edinburgh Award and has arranged this visit. So we've gone to D.C., Baltimore, and now New York with events with the Prince.
That's great.
It's been absolutely fantastic. We had many different events in Baltimore with student groups, all about this award, which really does do the same things that the Miss America organization really focuses on, with service, physical fitness, special skills, and an adventurous journey. It's an incredible award.
And there's another fascinating tidbit on your resume. That is, you love duct tape.
Yes, absolutely.
Why?
You're pro duct.
Yes. Well, I started making different things out of duct tape a couple years ago, and when the duct tape company found out about this year, I was able to go to the duct tape festival, judge the prom contest where students make their outfits
out of duct tape. Are these the winners?
This is one of the top 10. These are top 10 pictures you see right now.
Clothes made out of duct tape.
Absolutely.
Now, do you hate scotch and masking, or just prefer duct?
No, duct tape is just, it's a way to let your creativity out, you know, and that's what's so fun about it, is I encourage anybody to find those things that they love to do and make things out of
them. You've got a duct tape ring right there.
While at the festival, some students made me this ring, and it is great to see that these kids really are using their imaginations, being creative, and doing these things. Despite what people say, you can do those things that you love to do and find your passions and interests and go for
it. And these are your duct tape flowers.
Yes, they made these for me as well.
And the duct tape sash.
Yes. They made all of these for me.
You can do anything with this.
Absolutely.
I saw Apollo 13. Duct tape was very handy up there.
And I watched Apollo Creed with Rocky.
I'm sure you did as well. Teresa Scanlan, thanks so much for coming in. Best of luck with all of your many endeavors.
Thank you very much.
Future president, future Supreme Court justice.
Be nice to her, Steve.
No kidding.
She can really help you.
She'll be able to fix a ticket one day.
Yeah. Thank you guys so much for having me.